frequency distribution or percentage frequency distribution is a distribution in which each class frequency is replaced by a relative frequency or proportion or a percentage. The relative frequency of a class is found by dividing the frequency for a class by the sum of all frequencies. The percentage for a class is converting that decimal number from the ratio to a percent by multiplying by 100. The sum of the percentages in a relative frequency distribution should be 100% or very close to 100%. If it's not 100%, it's probably due to a few rounding errors that were unavoidable. We have again our McDonald's lunch service times in a frequency distribution, and we want to construct a relative frequency distribution. In order to do that, I find the ratio of each class's frequency to the sum of all the frequencies. Therefore, the first thing I need to do is find the sum of the frequencies. If I add up those numbers, 11 plus 24 plus 10 plus 3 plus 2, I find the sum of all the frequencies is 50. And I then can find the relative frequency by taking each one of the frequencies in the class and dividing it by the sum. This first relative frequency would be 11 divided by 50, which is 0.22. That would be one way to represent the relative frequency, or simply writing 22%. You then find the rest of the relative frequencies in a similar manner. 24 divided by 50 is going to give you 0.48 or 48%. 10 divided by 50 is 0.2, which is 20%. 3 divided by 50 is 0.06 or 6%, and 2 divided by 50 is 0.04 or 4%. If I add up my percentages, since I didn't have any rounding to do, it should equal 100. And it equals 100. Sometimes it's helpful to construct just one table to include the relative frequencies of distributions that are in more than one table. In this particular example, we have the amount of tar in milligrams in non-filtered cigarettes in one frequency distribution and the amount of tar from a sample of filtered cigarettes in another frequency distribution. Our directions tell us to construct just one table that includes the relative frequencies based on these distributions, and then to answer the question, do the cigarette filters appear to be effective? This would be what we would want to construct. We have our tar in milligrams, and notice I've combined all of the classes together. Or maybe you don't notice that right now, but in a minute I'll show you all on the same slide. We want to find the percentage relative frequency for the non-filtered cigarettes and then for the filtered cigarettes, and then answer our question. At the top of the page, you notice that this is the frequency distribution for the non-filtered cigarettes. This is for the filtered, and they don't have exactly the same classes, but they do have some classes in common. In my combined table, I start with the lower values in the lower class and upper class limits of the filtered cigarette information, and that's 2 to 6 and then 7 to 11. Both groups have the 12 to 16 and the 17 to 21, which I've reiterated here, and then the next three classes from the non-filtered would also go in the table. Then the next thing I need to do, because I'm creating a relative frequency distribution, is I need to know the sum of frequencies for each one of these distributions. So 2 plus 1 plus 13 plus 8 plus 1 gives me 25 for the sum of frequencies in the non-filtered cigarettes, and for the filtered cigarettes, I have 3 plus 3 plus 5 plus 14, which is also 25. 25 is a nice number to work with. In order to find the relative frequency for each group, I'm going to start with the 2 to 6 class. In non-filtered cigarettes, there are no counts in that class. In the filtered cigarettes, I have 3. So I'm going to divide 3 by 25, and that's 12. And because my table shows a percentage, I'm going to write the number 12 for 12%. 7 to 11, this doesn't have any counts in 7 to 11. We have 3 again for the frequency, which I've already calculated to be 12, so I can simply write 12. For the counts 12 to 16, we have 2 in the non-filtered cigarettes. 2 divided by 25 gives me 8%, so this is going to be 8. And then, filtered cigarettes has 5. 5 divided by 25 is going to give me 0.2 or 20%. And I would continue in this same pattern until I have all of the frequencies filled in. So why don't you go ahead and fill in the rest of the table and then resume the video and we'll compare notes. If you completed your table correctly, you would have ended up with the percentages as shown at the bottom of the screen. And remember, we did have a follow-up question to answer based on the information that's shown in our relative frequency distribution. Do the cigarette filters appear to be effective? If you think about the amount of tar in a cigarette, the lower the tar, the less unhealthy it is. And in the non-filtered, notice that we've got a high count or a few high counts in the upper range values of the amount of tar in a cigarette. Whereas if we look at the filtered sample, we have 0 cigarettes with those upper levels. It doesn't mean that the filtered cigarettes have no tar. It just means that non-filtered cigarettes, according to this comparison, have a lot more tar in them than filtered cigarettes. So the filters do appear to be effective. And the last type of frequency distribution we're going to look at in this particular section and course is called the cumulative frequency distribution. And once again, we have our McDonald's data in the frequency distribution at the top of the page. And in order to construct what's called a cumulative frequency distribution, we take the frequency for each class and add it to the next level of count in the next class, to get the cumulative frequency. For example, notice that there's a change in the way the classes column is worded. I'm going to look for the count in this first class. What would best describe that class in a cumulative manner? It would be the frequency of a class lower than 125. So in this case, the class is the number of seconds. So any counts that are less than 125 seconds would go in this first row, and that would be 11. And then for the next row, I want to move up to the next class. So what's below this class? Well, what would then be lower than 175 seconds, which is how that that row is worded with a count of 35. So where did 35 come from? Well, remember, we're going below this class, which means it would accumulate the count of 24 and 11, or 35. And then for less than the next class, let me get rid of some of the notation here. Moving right up, I want to know what count is less than this one, this class. So I want the count below this particular class, which is going to be less than 225. And the count is the sum 11, 24, and 10, which is 45. So this is called a cumulative frequency distribution. If you construct it correctly, what you find is that the last count in the right-hand column should be the total number of data points in the sample.